Hello everybody, they call me Muse and I welcome you back to Hitman Freelancer, where it's time for a new challenge. Now, we all know accidents will happen, and they're definitely going to today, because what we've got planned is an accident-only playthrough. For too long we've just been bipping people in the head with our silenced pistol, and luring them into quiet rooms and crunching them. And that's all well and good, but today our friends are going to be fire and water and gravity. So let's bring along some tools that will assist us in this job. We'll probably grab a few more once we know what we're doing, but I suppose we should actually select a campaign as well, you know. Now maybe eco would be best. It would certainly fit the bill. We could go and take on the waste manager in some fairly tricky maps, generally speaking. Let's give it a go. Shall we? So, probably save Columbia for the showdown. Of the three, it's probably my favourite for such matters, although let's check the challenges. Accident kill, excellent. Emetic, high target bodies, good, good. So, making a target slip in Bangkok, taking no damage and an accident kill. We don't appear to have any of the specific use of oil canister or use a water canister, so that's nice. Let's start with China. And let's see. Silent Assassin, Time to Hide and Seek. Time to Hide and Seek, because we're not going to be able to get any of the weapon kill ones, any of the melee weapon kill, sniper kill, headshots with legendaries or things like that. So we'll go with Time to Hide and Seek today. We could bring along rubber ducks in case we have to blow up cars next to people, but it might be nice to bring along some tools we don't use too often, like the micro taser. There's a proximity one which could come in handy, maybe? Or do we just bring the remote one? Let's bring the remote one. And then let's grab ourselves a Nana. And do the grapes take up inventory space? I know that there was a time when they did not. Let's find out if that's still the case. I have a feeling they changed this and the grapes now take up one inventory spot. So let's double check that. Yeah, they do. Okay. So we'll drop the grape knife for sure. We could bring a smaller pistol. We don't need to have the assassin's one. I'd like to keep the screwdriver and the wrench just because they enable opportunities for accidents. So yeah, let's grab a smaller pistol and then let's head to China. Now, it should be noted that accidents only applies to everyone, so I can't just choke someone out to get their outfit. They also need to be in accidents, so therein lies the real challenge, I feel. And now we've got a target in the block and a target in the facility. Because of course we've got two targets in wildly different parts. One's right up in Hush's private lab. Bloody marvellous. So, how does one get an outfit and get up to Hush's private lab? Oh, and we can only use one disguise as well, just to make things even more marvellous. Or at least that's the goal. We'll use a second disguise if we absolutely have to, but we'll try and avoid that. Now, those two lads are tricky to get by. Do we get a disguise for the block? Or do we get a disguise for the facility? Well, we can grab the street guard disguise there. But that doesn't really help us with either. Maybe we start with the facility, actually. It looked like we only had to go down one floor, so we might be able to sneak in there reasonably silently. You might have noticed I'm also wearing the new purple streak outfit as well. I was saying at the end of suit only that there just wasn't a better outfit that I'd rather have. But if you'd asked me to design a better outfit, I'd have said, well, something like the Black Streak, but with a purple shirt. And that's pretty much what we've got. I'm not sold hugely on the purple shoes. And the shirt does seem to glow a bit, like almost like it's missing a texture more than anything. But it's purple. I love purple. Therefore, it must be worn. Flash grenade, you say? I'll grab it. Now, we can't get past that guard, though, to get into the elevator shaft like we normally would. Well, we could throw something to just distract him out of the way long enough. But I don't see any easy ways to take him down accidentally, so let's sneak on in via this method.
Welcome.
Oh yeah, we should probably also find somewhere to hide.
Please follow the grey line to security check. Thank you.
Now, there's no hidey hole in here, is there?
You got cash? I might have something to sell.
There's a cupboard, good. Good, good. Now, who's coming in? Someone saw us sneaking about, so I'm glad this cupboard was here. So, can we turn off
security protocol overruled?
That would help us in the long run.
Security protocol overruled.
Now, guards are going back and forth there, but we should be able to get a dongle just in case we need one. I haven't figured out what we're going to do if everything hits the fan and we end up in a situation where we've got to shoot our way out of trouble. The general plan is run and hide until the heat dies down. But otherwise we might be in trouble because of the whole accident only rule that I've imposed. So we'll see. There's a lot of guards around. There's a lot of people around in general. Where would you go if I were to poison you? Now, who would come around this corner? Probably Red Coat would come around this corner if I were to distract someone. Because we've got the nanas for that, to distract people and get them out of the way. But then that still doesn't give us a kill. I should have probably bought an oil or a water canister thing along. Now, I think I'm gonna have to seek them. But I don't know where they're gonna go. Let's try sneaking in here.
Like you see it and know that's exactly.
There is a second banana, which is nice. So then we could put this on the floor here. And then grab our trusty ordinary screwdriver and toss it over there. And now hopefully our friend there slips on the banana. Yeah, he does. Good. So now we've got an outfit for this area at least. I think we will need it here. I think we'll have to figure out how to get around the block without a suit. Or maybe we'll have to bite the bullet and get the only used one disguise thing blown. And use a second one. It's always tricky when you've got one up, one down on Chongqing, but here we are. This is the situation we find ourselves in. No one on that side is looking at me, but that woman over there kind of was. Yeah. So just poisoning this guy could be tricky. I'm wondering if that guy will go through the vetting area and into the toilets over there. If he gets poisoned. I think he might do. But I guess there's only one way to find out, and that's to actually poison him. Doing that with everyone around. They've kind of got all the angles covered. Can anyone see us from here?
Because of his condition?
Yes, apparently. But they can't see us from here. Good. Just had to find the right angle. Now, where are you going, friend?
Ugh, what did you do to feel this way?
Yeah, he's going through to the toilets. So we'll go around the other way and meet him there. Just hop into a quick cupboard.
Why would anyone go in there?
To reset the timer, friend. Don't worry about it. I'm going to try not to rely on the Seeker too much. I don't want this to turn into Toilet Drowning Simulator 2023. But there's times when it's needed. And today it fits the challenges as well, so it's all good. And that's another objective complete. So now we've just got to get to the top floor of the block without changing disguise. And kill a target up there in an accident. Should be fine, right? Should be easy. Suppose we should also go and see our supplier friend. Let's see. Am I allowed in the security office as facility analyst? Good. We're getting close to another prestige, you know. I will have to do that partway through this campaign, probably. Well, I don't have to. But I like the prestige. I'm sure we'll do it at some point. Now, what do you have for us? Not a lot. But we're free to waltz out here. And now... we need to get up to the block. Whereabouts are we going to be... escaping the level? Will it be through that apartment door up there? Because I'm thinking I'm going to have to drop the briefcase somewhere, because we're not going to use it in the block. Is this the right code for this door? Yeah, it is. I wasn't sure if it's 2552. Because I associate this building with the block more than I associate it with the facility. So you'd expect it to have the block code of 2552, but I guess it doesn't. So there we go. No. So that's probably our exit from the level. So let's just drop our briefcase over here somewhere so no one comes over and grabs it. Now let's try and find a sneaky way into where we're going. I mean, it doesn't have to be ultra sneaky. We can still kill people. It's just killing people to make it look like an accident limits our options somewhat in that regard. But I know there's a guy we can shove off a ledge if we come up this way. I thought there was a guard here. But I guess there isn't today. Where's our pistol? We brought that along to turn off cameras and whatnot. So let's do that. Maybe I'll also reload the Seeker while I've got a moment, because you never know when you suddenly need to get a shot off. But we're getting fairly close to our target already. We just need to find a way of climbing to a higher floor. Like, say, a ladder. Do we bring the propane flask with us? Maybe. Is that going to attract attention, though?
Give me a second.
Doesn't look like it. So over we go. Well, we could poison this entire area by the look of it. I grew up in. Our target is a doctor who's roaming around over there somewhere. Now this is probably a 2552 door. And target is nearby now. That's good. He might be the one to hear that. And if he is, then he's going to come out and investigate. Oh no, it's here. Damn it. We haven't got any coins or anything. But we could do this.
Nothing. There's nothing here.
And down she goes. Now. We don't want her to be spotted though. So let's double up on this accident. By giving her another one. We're also about to run out of time again on hide and seek. Yeah, hide and seek's gone. This is sad.
Okay, back to real life.
Yeah, you go back. Oh, wait. What was that noise? You should probably go and investigate. Oh, dear. What a terrible accident. And down we go. And now it's just a case of getting out of Dodge. So folks up there have seen the explosion. Seen the results of it, I should say. Folks down here are also a bit panicky. It's like I just wandered off somewhere. Okay. That makes my life easier. And there you have it. That's the general gist of how this is going to go. We're going to cause some accidents and then we're going to scuttle away. Was that Silent Assassin?
No.
That might have been Silent Assassin, you know, so I should have gone for that instead of Timed Hide and Seek. But yeah, we took everyone out with accidents rather than anything else. We hid the bots except for the accident ones. At the very least, we filled our pockets with cool gear, and away we go. What toys have we earned for our troubles? A flash device, emetic pills, breaching charge. I mean, we probably want to keep the poison stuff on the go because we're going to need some of that at some point, I've no doubt. But now, Bangkok, make targets slip. Take no damage, accident kill. That's all fine. And Silent Assassin's the only option there that we could potentially get. So we'll do that. We'll grab our banana and grape again, and then we'll be off. Now, I feel like Bangkok is going to be rich with opportunities for accidents. Coconuts to be dropped on people's heads and whatnot. All sorts of antics. One of our targets is upstairs, though, but they're only in the cocktail bar. That's fine. Our other target is outside somewhere, just chilling. So they should be fine. Ah, it's an elusive target version on the map though, so I can't go to the cocktail bar just yet. So Kong will have to wait for now. I guess we'll go and see George Austin, see if we can't make him fall over. You lean over the edge there, that's cool. That helps us make you slip, I imagine. Let's see. Can't quite see where I'm placing the grapes because my bod gets in the way, but I think that should be a slip over. He would be easy enough to push off the edge, but there's a lot of witnesses around, so he might be a candidate for Seeker. Either way, let's see if he... Okay, he just walked straight past my grapes. But maybe when he does a circuit, he'll come back and then he will fall on them. Now, where would be a good place to Seeker him from? Over here, perhaps. This little corner is generally quite quiet. But now he's off again, and he's going to do what exactly? He's going to go and lean in a different spot. Oh, he's going to have a drink. So if we could get some poison, then that could take him out. Don't you be falling on those grapes, woman. Thank you. I was concerned there for a moment. Now, rat poison shouldn't be too hard to get because you can get that down in the basement, I'm sure. Can't remember exactly where, but I'm fairly sure rat poison's not difficult. But let's see. We can't do much else at the moment because we're waiting for the elusive targets to make their way up to the cocktail lounge or whatever. So we may as well just watch him for a moment. Look at these shoes. I mean, yeah, I would wear purple shoes, IRL. But I've got no taste, and I don't know anything about fashion. 47 is supposed to be a fashion expert. It's supposed to be one of the few things that he actually really appreciates in life. Fine dining and fine suits. And here he is wearing garish purple shoes. What's next, George? You're just going to go sit down. Whatever, you do your thing then. We'll see if we can find another way up.
Sir?
That allows us to find our target. Okay, so we can come up this way. But then, again, it's blocks off. Where are you going? You're following the gold digger. So it's the gold digger in X-Dictator. So I think that might mean that there's no way for us to get in there without a bodyguard outfit of some sort. Or a waiter's outfit. Oh dear. Our target has done a fall down. Lovely. So we could sneak in there, but that's staff only. This guy is going to come back out, and he is probably going to go into the staff only area, but then how do we cause an accident? Yeah, he's going to hang out over there somewhere. I mean, accidents in general are going to be tricky for this guy, I feel. What if we sneak in there? We're trespassing, but no one immediately saw us, but they probably would at some point. So yeah, I think he needs a disguise of some sort. Waiter outfit might be good. Can we lure a waiter into this room? Yeah, we can. So we could also put a banana down. Just there. Oh, how did Silent Assassin go? Did he see me, or did Silent Assassin go because the other guy was seen? I'll have to double check that to see if Silent Assassin had already gone or not. But I guess you can't make people slip and have their bodies found and get Silent Assassin in Freelancer. I really wish they'd sort out the Freelancer settings and rules properly, so that things made sense in and Freelancer behaved in the same way as it does in the regular game. Where you can lose Silent Assassin, but then you can regain it. I would like that. Now, is there rat poison in the kitchen somewhere? In, like, the freezer? Because I'm in a waiter's outfit now, so I can go ahead and poison people's drinks with impunity. I just need to find the actual poison. Let's go this way and have a look around in here. Yeah, here's some. Here's a screwdriver as well. We're not doing well on prestige objectives today. Sad times, because that's where all the money is as well. Although, thankfully we don't need money much right now, because we're going to prestige soon anyway.
Sure, I've got it.
But yeah, we've still got a few sniper rifles and whatnot, so we've still got a few things that we need to pick up. There is that waste there. She is standing in a position that makes it tricky for me to get down there, perhaps. Unless we can vault over here. And now he's in the middle of drinking. That's perfect timing. You've ruined everything, enforcer waitress.
Do you have cigarettes in the bar? No? Good. It's such a nasty, nasty habit.
Why'd you ask then, you weirdo? Perhaps I've got something for your champagne, though. This will give it a nice little kick. Where's my briefcase gone? Has someone located it already? I put it down for 1 second. I was like, it'll be fine there. It'll be safe. And yet, here we are. Someone's taken it to a nearby guard and they're going to drop it on the floor and be like, oi. But that's fine. We should be able to relocate it. So, where are you taking it? Guard friend. I mean, he's not taking it anywhere we can't get to. Are we allowed out here? Good.
Well,
okay.
Like
he's taking it downstairs.
Look, I can fix this. I'm homing in on the problem. I just gotta... Damn it!
No, he's taking it into the security office over there. Very
sure
well.
You don't want a ride home?
It's not
Let's
that.
Not worry about that for now. Because at some point our target is going to be on the move. So that you can have a little bath. Now, I hope he's actually going to go up to the bathroom. It's not terribly far away. I never really have a proper look at the backdrop in Bangkok.
Oh, shit.
Skyscrapers over there. Little huts over there. Big old temple. The whole of that area looks like it would be very interesting to explore as well. Instead, we just get a large building that could be anywhere in the world. But yeah, there's a certain anonymity in general to the areas. like Paris as well. It's just a large building that could be anywhere in Europe, really. They don't want realistic looking places, I think, because they don't want people complaining about how their city's been used for realistic looking shootouts in a video game. Oh, I don't want headlines like "Hitman inspired my son to go on killing spree by the Eiffel Tower" or something like that. Anyway, you just drown in a bog, friend. Just another tragic toilet-based accident. Happens all the time. Dozens of people a year just drown in their own toilets. Now, let's go grab our briefcase now. Can it hurt to grab it now? Can it hurt to grab it later? Maybe instead we head on up and see if we can't find our way into this cocktail lounge. So we're allowed here. This is good. So we could potentially fire a shot across the room and seek our boy. Be a long shot, eh? Whole lot of sus people around. This outfit's not terribly good when it comes to enforcers. They're everywhere. Now, let's leave again, because you're going to move a bit further back, aren't you, in a minute? Am I right? Okay. I'm sure earlier you were over here, stood next to this mop. But what would I know, apparently? Right, back he comes again. So the question is he going to go back to that coconut? Or is he going to go further up this time? Okay, so he does go further up sometimes. Good.
What does the metal taste, I wonder? Oh, God.
Right, now where are we going? I expect him to come out this way and go down the stairs. But instead, he's gone for a stroll elsewhere. Just as the other targets are coming past. But.
Hey, you okay?
Yeah, luckily.
Sir, you are not.
Go and find it.
Oh, God. What's going on? Why does that area suddenly become a frisk zone? There goes take no damage. Now everyone's going to try and kill us. God damn it. I've had some issues recently with zones just randomly becoming frisk zones. And it's most vexing. I guess that one at least makes some sort of sense because the ex-dictator was moving through, and therefore it became a high security area temporarily. But still, that's very annoying. And of course that's blown the ability to drown our waiter friend, because he's now going to go back to his normal routine at some point. No, we just need to wait for everyone to settle down, and then maybe we can get a tech crew outfit from Jackie's room. Maybe that's still there. I really hate this ex-dictator version of Freelancer. I might take it off at some point just because it causes so much hassle. But maybe that's just the salt talking. No. You're still on the floor. Do you have some clothes nearby that I could borrow? There we go, it's in the bathroom, thank goodness for that. Right, we're innocent again. But now we also don't have the ability to get up close and personal, because we're probably not allowed to roam around in the area anymore. Let's see.
Sorry, sir, I can't let you through. Got my orders.
Yeah, we're not allowed through there. Okay, so we can get back to here. We could basically repeat that, except this time we go around the long way rather than trying to run through the bodyguards. Right, which way are you going, waiter friend? Are you going coconuts or are you going further in? It's going further in. Which means, yes, we can just do that again. Could have put the gun away a bit quicker, though. But it looks as though we haven't spooked our target, and he is still on the move. So yeah, second try might have done it. Although getting our briefcase back could be tricky this time, because we're now no longer in an outfit that allows us to go into the security office.
Please don't. Oh.
But once again, we're drowning someone in a bog. It's just a shame he's a waiter as well, so we can't take his outfit because it's so heavily compromised. Although, where is it compromised? Yeah, it's compromised all over this upper floor, so... yeah. So, do we go on a top stealthy mission to try and get back our briefcase? Or do we try and cause a guard accident via some other method? Now, are there any easy guard accident opportunities down in the basement? Not that I can recall. Are there any around this side of the hotel whilst I'm here? I should have bought the proximity microtaser after all, because you can just throw that to a guard and then they get electrocuted by it when they pick it up. But there's also a hose, so electrocuting a guard could be possible. Let's turn on the old faucet. Make a little puddle. Grab the old micro taser. And we'll just drop it right there. Now, I think I could probably trigger it right now and it would just make the electrified puddle, which the guard would then run into. Yep. Yeah, keep walking, friend. And down he goes. Another tragic accident. And in the box with you. Gardner nearly saw us boxing the lad, but that's fine. Now we can go about our nefarious business and grab back our briefcase. And then we can bugger off. Only 2 out of 4 challenges this time, which is unfortunate. But there we go. I still have to double check what exactly happened to Silent Assassin. Because if it was the slip that caused it, then that sucks, because that shouldn't be Silent Assassin breaking and wouldn't be in campaign. But if it's that the waiter spotted us and got sus just before he fell over with the banana, then that's my own fault for not hiding in a cupboard. But either way, the footage will reveal that. And for now, we'll just move on with our lives. What's our prize today? It's to get the microtaser back. Lovely. Now, eliminate leader with oil or water canister trap sounds just perfect. Who is our leader, though? Are they a smoker by any chance? No, they're sweet tooth and dehydrated. Shame. Accident kill, hide target bodies. Poison emetic. So poison emetic suggests, again, a toilet situation. But if we know where they're going to throw up, then we could pop down an oil canister and then we could shoot it when they go there to bomb. So maybe that's an option. Maybe to be on the safe side, we'll bring along some emetic pills. High target bodies might go, just because they might end up throwing up somewhere pretty public. But we will see. Maybe I can just knock them out in the toilet, and then pour oil next to them, and then light them on fire. Maybe that's allowed. That's close enough. It's still an accident, right? Okay, so it looks like it's Embrace of the Serpent. That's fine. We can live with that. Let us whip out the old camera. So we've got a target over there. We've got one up in the town and we've got 2 in the mansion. Can we see this target over here, or are they too hidden for us? One thing I hadn't considered about this map, but is now going to come in very handy, is that because we need accidents to take people out, it can be tricky to get disguises. But There's one right here for the taking on Columbia, so it is all ours. Let's go. Oh no, our target's over there now. And they are a smoker, so not the one. Very well, we don't even need to come this way. Let's see if our supplier friend has anything for us whilst we're here.
You name it, I got it. Sure.
Now, do some freelance tools. It's worth grabbing them when I can. Let's see, it looks as though we've got the band playing. Very nice. Statue has been unveiled. Sounds like the drums are playing, even though the drummer is still dead in a building somewhere. My immersion is ruined. Now, who are you?
Yeah, that's...
Yeah, you've got a necklace. Is that an earpiece in your ear there? Maybe. You've got a hat. Don't think you've got hair.
What I like to see.
You are suspect number one. Alright, you're off to a meeting, are you? So you're not going to do any suspicious activities whilst you're doing that. Grab another coin, because you can never have too many. Now, if it is this guy, though, where is he drinking? We're not going to get any tells from him right now, because he's off to a meeting. So let's go and look at the other two and see if they fit any of the bills. All these guards hanging out by the door, and not one of them's an enforcer. Now, you are hatless. Get off my list. They have an assassin. They have a hat, and they lack hair. They're definitely sus. Can I just quickly... Yeah, you fit all the bills as well. So, now we need to watch for tells. Sweet tooth and dehydrated. Okay, so they're strong off towards the construction site by the look of it. This guy's an accident waiting to happen. So let's just make that. Now these lads... both enforcers, so if we can just quietly... stroll past you. Okay, we can't quietly stroll past you. That's fine, we'll just run away. I don't think that's going to spook the target. Yeah, target looks unspooked. So that's good. And everyone's gone back to normal. Isn't there an emetic flower here? Yeah, we'll have that. Might not need our pills after all. So, a lot of enforcers around here for this outfit. A lot of opportunities for accidents around here though as well. Right, so she's just standing about over there. Please do something, madam. She's reading a book. I briefly saw the book icon there. She's not the one. Which means it was a capped friend. So let's go find out where he drinks, shall we? I mean, we don't necessarily need to. But that is an option. We could seek him. And then once we know where he drinks, we could just pour some oil in front of his drink. Now, let's see. Drinks at the bar. That makes sense. Although I've not seen him do it yet, so... which is a shame, because that would be a good place to get him, because of the toilet that's right next to it. Yeah, maybe it's worth just doing that. TBH. Right, that confirms he is the target. Now, come down to the bar, my friend. Yeah, he's gonna make his way in here, I feel. As it is indeed a toilet.
Damn.
Okay.
Well, let me help you. Without.
So we pop some oil down. We pop out here, grab our gun. And there we go. We lost high target bodies because we didn't wait for the door to close. But we got everything else. He suffered a tragic accident. And now we can scuttle away. I could have waited for the doors to close and then just knocked him out while he was puking and then dragged him back a bit to the oil and set him on fire. But I'm trying to avoid knockouts wherever possible because it doesn't really fit the accident thing unless the knockout comes from a slip or a trip. But I'll take 3 out of 4. That's fine. And away we go. A first level complete. That's not the exit 47, that's a bench. You idiot. And now our reward, which should just be Mercer's. Yeah, lovely. And our secondary reward, which is flash device. More poison? Maybe more poison. Can't go wrong. How close are we to finishing one of the other challenges? Because there is a challenge for killing people with accidents, and I don't think I've finished it yet. Yeah, there it is, Puzzle Master. 24 or 25, so we're going to get that done very soon. We're going to get that done next time, perhaps, if we can get through 4 missions. But for now, thank you very much for watching, friends, and I'll see you next time.